to the 61st annual All-Sports Gala here at Providence College. My name is Kaylee Griffin. I was a member of the class of 2014, and I am so excited to be here with you guys all tonight. It's a very special evening here in Friartown to honor so many of the accomplishments from all of you student athletes and all of the programs here. So I am so honored to be a part of it, and it's going to be a really special night. We're going to start this ceremony off with a special video message from Providence College President Father Sicard.
Good evening, everybody. I'm pleased to welcome you to our 61st annual All-Sports Gala. While I wish I could be there in person, I'm on the road, but I appreciate the opportunity to offer greetings. Like so many things recently, it's nice that we're back to having events like this in person, together in one place, and without masks. The opportunity for our community to be together at Friar games and meets over the past few months has been important to getting back to normal. That sports are an important part of the fabric of our community life and our season, and what a season it's been. You have collectively represented PC with strength, determination, and class. From the women's soccer team qualifying for the NCAA tournament to the unforgettable men's basketball season with everything in between, Friar student athletes and coaches have shown the world what Providence College is all about. We are all grateful. Your excellent work in the classroom continues with a 97% graduation rate. You've given thousands of hours to community organizations and raised money to support the great causes. Across the board, you make us proud. I can't let this opportunity pass without pointing out that I appreciate the commitment it takes to be a student athlete and all that entails. Despite the demands, you collectively succeed in competition, in the classroom, and in the community. I also recognize the particular challenges for many of you this year as you've had to manage the transition back to in-person classes from the strangeness of the 2020-2021 season, on top of the ongoing coronavirus challenges that were really in full view until just recently. And just a word for the women who represent PC so well through athletics. In a year when we have focused much attention on the 50th anniversary of the enrollment of the first class of women, I want to extend my appreciation. We have come so far, and thanks to your example, Friar women of the future will continue to exemplify the best of Providence College. The year-long celebration might be almost over, but the momentum will continue. Now, tonight is bittersweet, of course, because it's the last of these events before Bob Driscoll's retirement. And Bob has been my friend and colleague since we began working together in 2005, and I will always treasure that relationship. Bob has been one of the best leaders in the history of Providence College. His vision and energy have driven us to new heights, and he leaves PC Athletics prepared for even more greatness. Thank you, Bob. I'm excited about Steve's leadership, and I'm happy that Bob will always be part of our Friar family. On that note, let me conclude with Bob's signature sign-off and expression of best wishes. Go Friars!
Well, now it is my pleasure to introduce a man who truly needs no introduction around here, Athletic Director Bob Driscoll.
Thanks, Karen. Thank you, Beth. I'm pretty excited tonight. I was in the lobby over there taking pictures with the seniors, and my heart was racing. I kind of felt what maybe what Tom Brady felt like, right? Walk around the world, people want to take pictures. So after having that experience, I decided I may not retire after all. What do you think, Kev? That was a joke. Come on, you laugh. I wanted to say thank you to my great teammate, Steve Napolillo, who's going to be taking over leadership here. He's a young man that deserves this opportunity with our great staff. I know we're going to have great success. So please give our new leader a nice round of applause. Coach. I also want to thank Kaylee, a graduate of Providence College, for making the effort to come back. We're so proud of what she's done in the sports industry, and she's a prime example of what a Providence College degree will do with hard work, dedication, and commitment. So please give our fire team a nice round of applause as well. I also want to thank my Dominican teammates. I mean, we're blessed to work at such an amazing institution with men that you can trust. You have a handshake and what they say is real. So could I have my Dominican teammates please stand up and give these men a nice round of applause, please? So this is my 21st event, and they gave me 5 minutes, but I told Jen, since this is my last go around, I'm gonna take a few minutes more, so I hope you'll indulge me. But I gotta say, you know, I do this for a living, but I'm a little nervous, because I love you all, and I wanna represent you with dignity and class. So I asked my son, Sean, who's a Providence College graduate, I said, do you have any advice for me? I'm gonna meet my teammates and talk to them. I haven't talked to them in person for 3 years, and he goes, oh, Dad. Old guy like you, you're not going to be able to connect with those young people. They've passed you by. I go, what? What are you talking about? I said, give me some advice. He said, first of all, don't be charming. I said, all right, I can do that pretty naturally. Just ask my wife. Then he said, and don't be funny. I go, all right, I won't be funny. And he said, above all, don't be intelligent. He said, just be yourself and you'll do just fine. So he's no longer getting tickets to any of the basketball game, Ed, so I'll tell you right now. But I'm going to be myself tonight, not that I haven't, but I want you to know a little bit about my love for Friartown. I have three passions in my life. One is my family, my wife and children and grandchildren. One is sports. Sports has given me the life I could only have dreamed of, as all of you. So I love sports, competing, coaching, teaching, leading. And thirdly, I love music. You may not know this, but in sixth grade, I got the best certificate for dancing. And you know I can dance, right? Oh, horrible. Ed and I win the karaoke contest every year down at Ponte Vedra. I noticed the other day that Lee Reed, my teammate down at Georgetown, they had their event, and Lee was dancing on stage, the students were dancing, and I said, I can't let that happen. So, you know, I'm a big video guy. I like to find motivational videos and things that make you happy. You know what makes me happy? When I see a performer or an athlete do world-class things. We go to the shows together, go to Broadway. Believe it or not, I played the drums and I have a band. And when I retire, I'm going back to do that again. So I'm going to kick off tonight with a video. Father, great musician to the left. You know the love we have for music. So I was watching the Grammy Awards the other day, and a gentleman named John Baptiste, who was on campus 3 years ago and performed, is an amazing, amazing person. Anybody see his performance of Freedom at the Grammy Awards recently? Wow, nobody owns a television set. That's amazing. So just to set the tone, because you'll see a lot about videos, about sport, I want you to watch this video, and if you want to dance, get up and dance. I may show you some of my moves up here as well. If anybody up here, Timmy, you want to join me, man, I can show you some of my spin moves, whatever you want. But this is going to set the tone for tonight, because tonight's a celebration. I know you're going to go dancing tonight later on. You might as well start right now. So if we could dim the lights and kick off this video that makes you want to move your body. How much fun was that, huh? So, I had a whole bunch of life's lessons I wanted to talk about, but I'm not gonna talk about it because you know what? The life's lesson is to have fun. Life is short, be all in, and be the best person that you can absolutely be. So, did anybody hear a message in his song? Did you hear what he had to say? Is anybody, what was the whole purpose of the song? What did he talk about? Well, the song was called Freedom, and he said, be who you want to be. And that means walk through life and own it. Don't cover yourself up with armor because you're afraid to show who you are, because you're afraid that people will judge you, that you're afraid that the outside world won't love you. But I will say to you, and it took me a long time, and tonight was me saying, I'm going to be who I am in front of my teammates. And you know what? You're going to love me either way because it was fun, right? That's better. We kicked Lee Reed's ass tonight down at Georgetown. I'll tell you right now. So I just want to, from the bottom of my heart, my mission and purpose and vision in life was always to be a teacher, a mentor, and a coach. I was the first person in my family to go to school. My dad drove a truck. He fought in World War II. My mom cleaned houses. I got three children. One went to Providence, one went to Michigan, one went to Cal, and I got a little granddaughter, 9-year-old, and she's going to become a friar someday. So I guess what I'm saying to you is thank you from the bottom of my heart for allowing me to do what I do, and that's to coach and teach. And every day that I interact with you, you keep me young and alive. So love you very much. And remember, as always, go Friars. Thank you. Thank you. So let the fun begin. Kaylee, it's all yours.
I don't really know how we follow this up now, but we're gonna try. Okay, so we are gonna start off tonight with the academic awards. At this time, we would like to recognize the senior male and senior female student athlete with the highest cumulative GPA as our senior scholar athletes. Our male senior scholar athlete is Matthew Murakami from lacrosse, and our female senior scholar athlete is Nicola Calabrese from women's track and field. Yes, you guys come up. You should have said that before. Everyone to stand who earned Athletic Director Honor Roll for the fall of 2021. That's a 3.0 GPA or above. The president of the Student Athlete Advisory Council to speak and reflect on his or her time at Providence College. Please welcome to the stage senior Rainier Lee from lacrosse.
Hey everyone. I am so thankful to be here in front of you having our first in-person gala in 2 years. This year has been one to remember. Thanks to our collective efforts, we were able to get safely back to a regular 3-season athletic calendar, stop wearing masks, and take a huge step closer to normalcy. I have truly cherished my time at Providence College, and I am so thankful for the close-knit relationships that I have made with my teammates and athletes all across the different teams here. Friartown is a truly special place, and the people here are what make it so great. As my time at the school comes to a close, I can't help but reminisce on some of the things that I love about PC Athletics. It's hard to beat cheering for the soccer team in the fall when the weather's nice and the sun sets behind the chap. I will miss screaming my heart out at the dunk and cheering for the hockey team. I might even miss waking up at crazy early hours for morning workouts. What I value most about my time at Providence, though, is the people. I'm so thankful for the welcoming environment that we have. I do not have enough time to thank everyone who has made my time at this school so special, but there are a few people I would like to thank. First off, thank you to my teammates. I am so thankful to have a group of 46 guys that I can call my best friends. Thank you to Coach Gabs, Coach Fran, and Coach Gould for giving me the opportunity to come and compete at the highest level. Thank you to Jen and Shannon for putting up with me for the past 2 years and giving me your never-ending support. Thank you, Mr. Driscoll, for your work at PC for the past 2 decades. Thank you to Steve Knapp and Jill Point for giving so much support and care to the athletic program. And of course, a huge thank you to my fellow exec members, Remy, Lisa, Brenna, and Jamie, for being the best support system I could have asked for. And finally, thank you to Coach Rick, Coach Anderson, and Coach Amy for helping me push to become the best athlete that I can be. It was so refreshing to be able to attend each other's games this year. Thanks to everyone's cooperation and willingness to work along COVID prevention efforts and vaccinations, we were able to go to all the games we wanted to, all over campus and at the Dunk. Truly, it made me proud to be a Friar. Before we get into all that we accomplished this year, I want to talk about the year-long celebration of the 50th anniversary of women at PC and in athletics. The school obviously looks so much more different than what it would have if it weren't for these strong women who have come through this place, and it is a much better place thanks to these women. This school year was full of great accomplishments throughout the athletic department. In the fall, the soccer teams started out strong. Men's soccer had a great season as they defeated Georgetown, who was the top-ranked team in the country at the time, and we finished 16th overall. They advanced to the third round of the tournament for the fourth time in program history, and this marked their 11th NCAA appearance in program history. Women's soccer made the NCAA tournament for the second time in program history, and the first time since 1993. The women's cross country team qualified for the NCAA championships and finished 26th overall in the nation. This was their 29th appearance in program history and first since 2017. On the men's side, Marcelo Roca earned a spot at the NCAA cross country championships with a 61st overall finish. Then the winter. The winter was marked by the remarkable run by our men's basketball team. They won the Big East regular season championship for the first time in program history and advanced to their Sweet 16 for the first time in 25 years. Coach Cooley was named National Coach of the Year. Nate Watson and Jared Bynum were named to the All-Big East second team, and Jared was also the Sixth Man of the Year for the Big East. For indoor track, Shannon Flockhart was crowned Big East Mile Champion. For swimming, 7 athletes were named to the All-Big East team. Congrats to Brian Canton, Kevin Hood, Aiden Hughes, Justin Viotto, Montgomery Brown, and Ryan Sharp for this achievement. These accomplishments are all well-deserved. I know how hard we work to achieve these things, and it takes a special kind of person to be able to play a Division I sport. I am proud of all of you for doing hard things and representing the school in such an honorable way. I hope that all of you take your time at PC to grow and mature as a student, as an athlete, and as a person. Just the fact that you're here shows that you're doing things that not many people can, and it speaks volumes to your character. I want to leave you with a couple lines from a poem that I've found that has helped me during hard times. In William Ernest Henley's poem, Invictus, he ends by saying, "It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishments the scroll, I am the master of my fate, I am the captain of my soul." So go out and be the masters of your own fates and captains of your own souls. Thank you, and as always, go Friars.
Now we would like to recognize the individuals and teams who captured Big East titles or advanced to the NCAA postseason competition.
Kenny lays it across, looking for Hughes. Hughes inside and scores! Into the box, a bicycle kick and a finish! What a fantastic effort for Kyla Gallagher!
Mac Hughes, what was a beautiful pass. Hughes scores!
Rolls it around the head of the goal! The Friars leading this 1-0. Garcia over the wall, takes a deflection and in! And the Friars strike first! Plays it off for Wilson. Wilson with some space. Trying to drive it towards the net and in! An absolute golazo for Armand Wilson! And the Friars back on it. The cross comes in, diving! It's David!
Marcus Smith, the UMass transfer, punches Providence's ticket to the round of 16.
I don't know why, but I feel like me.
Teams. We would now like to take a few minutes to pay tribute to our athletes' community service in the 2021-2022 academic year. Your efforts in this area are what make Friartown such a special place.
Thank you.
We're now going to get into some individual awards. So if you are the recipient, I'm going to ask you to come up onto the stage after your name is called. The Mal Brown Award was established in 1940 in the memory of Malcolm H. Brown, former Providence College athletic trainer. This award is given annually to a graduating male senior whose athletic career of intercollegiate competition portrayed the qualities personified by Mal Brown: sportsmanship, courage, and honor.
The nominees for the Mal Brown Award are Michael Callahan, men's hockey; Al Durham, men's basketball; Evan McGreen, lacrosse; and Malcolm Duncan, men's soccer.
And here to present this prestigious award is the president of the Mal Brown Club, Liz Cattucci, class of 2004.
Thank you so much. I don't know where to begin. I kind of want to dance, Bob. Just to be able to witness that tonight was absolutely amazing. So thank you. I'm very honored to be here in front of you today. As Kaylee mentioned, I graduated in 04. I have very strong ties to the school still, and I had the opportunity to see my girls for the Friar Serve program. They all go to St. Pius, and I see a few of the volunteers here tonight. So I couldn't be more honored to be here and more honored to be presenting this award. This senior has represented Providence College in a first-class manner all year. He came in and helped change the culture of his team and was a terrific ambassador on and off the court. Most impressively, he played the last 2.5 months of the season with a sports hernia. Despite this injury, he was still able to make major contributions to the team and help continue this magical season. This senior led his team to a Big East regular season title and the first Sweet 16 appearance in 25 years. I could not be more excited to announce this year's winner of the Mal Brown Award, Al Durham. Unfortunately, Al could not attend tonight's gala. Accepting in his honor is Coach Cooley. Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Memorial Award was established in 1977 in memory of Paul Connolly, Providence College's former Director of Alumni Development and Public Information. This award is presented annually to a senior female athlete who has distinguished herself amongst her peers. It is the mirror of the Mal Brown Award.
The nominees for the Paul Connolly Memorial Award are Natalie Benson, volleyball; Cameron Kelbaugh, field hockey; and Christina Rogers, women's soccer.
This fifth-year student graduated in the fall of 2021 and returned to complete her master's in education. This past fall, she started in every game and led a young team to the NCAA tournament for the first time since 1993. She was a vital part of the team's leadership council and a great example of sportsmanship and honor on and off the field. Ladies and gentlemen, this year's winner of the Paul Connolly Memorial Award is Christina Rogers from women's soccer. It is now time to present the Sine Qua Non Award for both a male and female student athlete. Sine Qua Non, that without whom there is nothing. This award was established by the Newport Area Alumni Club. It is given to both a graduating male and female student athlete who has distinguished him or herself amongst his or her peers without receiving proper recognition.
The nominees for the Sine Qua Non Award for a male athlete are Jimmy Scannell, men's hockey, Noah Horkler, men's basketball, AJ Ernst, men's track, Matt Grillo, lacrosse, and Simon Triantafilou, men's soccer.
This fifth-year graduate student was a key cog in the men's basketball team's run this season, but he never once earned individual honors. He simply went about his business quietly and efficiently. While he may not have been appropriately recognized, he came up big for the Friars in key moments this season. He scored 25 points against St. Peter's in November, a team that advanced to the Elite Eight, and had 16 points and 14 rebounds against Richmond to advance to the Sweet 16. Ladies and gentlemen, this year's winner of the Sine Qua Non Award is Noah Horkler from men's basketball. For the Female Sine Qua Non Award.
The nominees for the Sine Qua Non Award for a female athlete are Mackenzie Taylor, volleyball, Maria Coffin, women's track and cross country, Haley Lunny, women's ice hockey, Olivia Ward, field hockey, and Amber Birchwell, women's soccer.
This fifth year established herself as a selfless, appreciative, caring, helpful, and loyal teammate and leader from day one. Throughout her career at Providence College, she overcame injuries and during these past 2 years navigated many obstacles during the COVID-19 pandemic. The native New Zealander would wake up in the middle of the night for classes on Zoom or to attend team meetings. Through these challenges, this fifth year never complained and only maintained her positive attitude and approach to life. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this year's Sine Qua Non Award is Olivia Ward from field hockey. We would like to present the Jane Thompson Award. This award was established in 2005 and is the only award given in memory of one of our former student athletes. Jane was one of you. A native of Halifax, Nova Scotia, Jane Thompson was a member of our women's swim team graduating in 1999. Jane was born with and lived her life with cystic fibrosis. She never let her disease get in her way. Her zest for life was evident to all who knew her. Jane loved being a student athlete. She loved being a PC Friar. In 1999, Jane was the recipient of the Paul Connolly Award. In July of 2003, Jane passed away from complications of her illness. She was just 26 years old. This humanitarian award is presented to the male or female senior student athlete that through the course of his or her career at PC has set him or herself apart from fellow student athletes in areas of public and community service, as well as outreach to others. An individual who shows selflessness and caring for those around them and looks to what they can do to help others without the need to be recognized. An individual who personifies all that is good about being a student athlete at Providence College and exhibits selflessness, dedication, loyalty, loyalty, courage, and perseverance under the most extreme personal circumstances.
The nominees for the Jane Thompson Award are Emma Fink, volleyball. Olivia Ward, field hockey. Selena Falzerano, women's soccer. And Rainier Lee, lacrosse.
This year's winner has truly gone above and beyond during his time as a student athlete at Providence College. He is currently the president of SAC and prior to this year served as the vice president and chairperson of the mental health subcommittee in the 2020-2021 year. He is also a member of the Providence College Finance Society and Blockchain Club and an athletic department marketing student worker. He also excelled in the classroom and was named to Dean's List and Big East Academic Honor Roll on multiple occasions. He is known for his legacy of selflessness and caring, just as Jane Thompson was. Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the Jane Thompson Award is Rainier Lee of lacrosse. Is in honor of Reverend Robert A. Morris, class of 1946. The college's mission statement speaks of the power of grace to enlighten minds, open hearts, and transform lives. To those who knew him, there was no one who lived that mission more fully than Father Robert A. Morris. For almost 60 years, he was a central figure in the Providence College community, most especially to our coaches, staff, administrators, and most importantly, our student athletes. He was truly committed to the development of our students and was a tireless supporter of Friar Athletics. This award is presented annually to a student athlete who has had a profound impact on Providence College during their careers. The recipient of the fifth annual Father Robert Morris Award is Nate Watson. Nate is unfortunately able to attend tonight's gala, and accepting the award tonight in his honor is men's basketball special assistant LaDonte Henton. Was the first recipient of this award back in 2015. Yeah. Now, before we present these next awards, we would like to ask that each recipient say a few words after receiving these honors. It is now time for this year's Female Athlete of the Year for an individual sport.
The nominees for Individual Female Athlete of the Year are Laura Mooney, Women's Cross Country and Track, and Katie Mulvey, Tennis.
This year's award goes to Laura Mooney from Women's Cross Country and Track.
On a very young cross-country team, Laura was. On a very young cross-country team, Laura was the one constant. You could always rely on her to give a consistently good performance. Her runs at the Wisconsin Invitational, the Big East Conference, and NCAA Northeast Regional Meets helped in getting the team a bid to the NCAA Championships. She was named on the All-Big East and All-NCAA Northeast Regional Teams, was again our lead runner at NCAAs. She followed a cross-country season with a great indoor season, which culminated at the Big East Championships, where she finished second in the 5,000 meters and third in the 3,000 meters, earning all Big East honors in both events. She's already qualified for the first round of the NCAA Outdoor Championships in the 5,000 and 10,000 meters. Our Athlete of the Year for individual sports, Laura Mooney.
Everyone, I'm a little bit nervous, but you know, I'll try. I'm really grateful here today to receive this reward, and it's lovely to be here in front of you all. And I really appreciate all the help and support that I've got throughout my time here in Providence College. It's really been brilliant. I really want to give a big thanks to everyone that has helped me throughout my time here, and especially to my coach, Ray Tracy, who has really taught me the importance of patience. You know, patience is a virtue, and I really, really learned that. And I also want to say thanks to Kat and Tim, who are always there to help and to supply all the good shoes. I also want to thank everyone in the training room, in the athletic training room, and especially to Grace, who's our trainer, and she's really, really helped me really, really well this semester, and it means a lot. I also want to thank Coach White in the fueling station, who's been fueling me up with cherry juices every night. A good sleep, cherry juice, plenty of it. And I also want to thank everyone in the Innovation Lab, and especially John Rock. He knows that I utilize that facility. I also want to thank Bob Driscoll, who we'll miss dearly, and also Steve Napoli and Jill Lapointe, and everyone in the athletic department. And I want to thank our team chaplain, Father Humbert, and I can tell you one thing, he'll know the result of your race before you know it yourself. And I also really want to give thanks to all the friars, especially Father Vidmar, Father Nick, and Sister Anne Frances, who've really been there for me in times of doubt, and through Jesus Christ, and especially through Our Lady, who has guided me through every step of my journey here. And just before I finish, I just want to say something to everyone here today, that sometimes we doubt ourselves and we doubt our abilities and we let negative thoughts feed us. But you know what? The sky is the limit. We don't have any limits. The sky is the limit. And the body achieves what the mind believes. A little bit of hardship does no one any harm, and it only builds resilience. And sometimes the only way to learn and grow, we need to be outside our comfort zone. And you know what? When someone asks you and thinks that you're mad, you tell them there's a method to your madness. So thank you very much, everyone, and go Friars.
Now for the Female Athlete of the Year from a team sport.
Nominees for Female Team Athlete of the Year are Allison Barber, volleyball. Sandra Abstrider, women's ice hockey. Amanda Collins, field hockey. Meg Hughes, women's soccer, and Janae Crooms, women's basketball.
This year's award goes to Meg Hughes from women's soccer.
Meg's dynamic ability to create scoring opportunities for herself and her teammates make her one of the top attacking players at both the conference and national levels. She led the team in goals, points, shots, and shots on goal while ranking top five in goals, points and goals per game, and overall shots within the Big East Conference. For her efforts in her second season, and after being placed on the preseason All-Big East team, Meg earned All-Big East first team, All-East regional second team, and All-New England first team after a successful freshman campaign where she was named Freshman of the Year and placed on the All-Freshman and All-Big East second team. Her athletic ability and success goes beyond the soccer field. While competing with the track and field program at Providence College for indoor track, Meg earned All Big East honors at the Big East Championship in the distance medley relay, helped her team set a school record in the 4x400 meter relay at the Big East Indoor Championship, and set the Providence College record for the 400 meter hurdles. She is currently ranked third in the Big East in the 400 meter hurdles for outdoor track. Meg is the first Providence College student athlete to earn all Big East honors in two distinctly different sports, soccer and track, since 1995. Although Meg is an extraordinarily talented and driven athlete, her greatest qualities are her selflessness, care, and love for her teammates. She puts the team before individual glory and celebrates her teammates' success more than her own. On behalf of both programs, women's soccer and track and field, congratulations to Meg Hughes, your Female Team Athlete of the Year award.
Hello.
Sorry, I'm so nervous.
I just wanted to thank my family, friends, and teammates for all their support. I also wanted to thank all my coaches, including Coach Lopes and Coach Tracy and all their staff, all of whom believed in me and gave me the chance to come to Providence College. I also would like to thank all the other people in the athletic department here at Providence who helped me create an environment where I can grow and develop as an athlete, but more importantly, as a person. Lastly, I would like to thank and appreciate all the other student athletes and especially the seniors for a great year in Friartown. Thank you and go Friars.
Our next award of the evening is for the Male Athlete of the Year in an individual sport.
The nominee for Individual Male Athlete of the Year is Marcelo Rocha, men's cross country and track.
And guess what? This award goes to Marcelo Rocha.
Marcelo has been the backbone of the cross-country team for the last 2 years. He was all Big East in the spring championships of 2021. He followed that up with his best ever track season, which culminated in him qualifying for the NCAA final in 10,000 meters. He was named Honorable Mention All-American after the season. All led to a great cross-country season this past fall, where he finished fourth at the conference championship and ninth at the NCAA regional meet, earning him all Big East and all Northeast regional honors. His performance earned him an individual spot at the NCAA championships. Joining his sister Katarina as an individual athlete of the year at Providence College is Marcelo Rocha.
Hey everyone, as my teammates know, I'm not much of a talker, so I'll keep it short and sweet, but I'm truly honored to receive this award. I was nominated last year and was truly grateful to receive the acceptance this year. And I'm very grateful to all of the people in the athletic department, like Joe LaPointe and Bob Driscoll, who will be missed shortly for the next. Your legacy is truly remarkable and will never be forgotten. And Steve Napoli, I can't wait for your leadership in the next couple years and forever. And going on to the next point, my biggest inspiration was definitely my coaches, Ray, Tim, and Kat, for all of their support they've given me over the last 4 years and going on to my next two. I know that it's been a long road, a lot from injuries and coming up as a freshman, but I am very happy with what I've accomplished for you guys. And I'm thank you to the training staff, especially for Kristen and Grace and Jesse for all of the roads to recovery they helped me along with. And lastly, to my teammates, thank you for all the workouts and long runs we do together all summer and all season. I know that this upcoming cross-country season will be a special one, and I can't wait. So thank you all, and go Friars.
Our next award of the evening is for the Male Athlete of the Year for a team sport.
The nominees for Male Team Athlete of the Year are Nate Watson, men's basketball. Jared Bynum, men's basketball, and Paolo Lima, men's soccer.
This year's award goes to Nate Watson of men's basketball.
Hey, Nate, first I want to congratulate you on this outstanding award that is very well deserved. For everybody watching and listening, Nate is an incredible human being, a better person, always has an incredible smile, never has a bad day, always is approachable, always has something positive to say to people. He has an infectious personality. And Nate, as your coach and as a person who really appreciates the value you brought to Providence College men's basketball and all of our community, we wish you nothing but the best in your next chapter of life at the professional ranks. Nate, you will go down as one of the greatest Friars in the history of Friar basketball. You are a champion, you are a graduate, and a person we all are very proud of. Congratulations on this award. I look forward to us growing together and growing old together as you move on in life. Take care. I love you, Nate Watson.
What's up, Friar Town? Sorry I couldn't be there today, but I just wanted to say thank you for this award. It's been a pleasure being a part of this program for the last 5 years. You know, the level of love, the energy, the passion that you guys showed for us this year was just, it was on another level, and it was amazing. And these are memories that I will remember forever. So, like I said, I just wanted to say thank you to all the coaches, the faculty and staff, the students, everyone in Friar Town. Thank you for this award. You know, it's a little sad for me because I won't be in college again. You know, I won't see you guys that much anymore, but you know, every time I get a chance, I will come to some games, you know, say what's up to some teachers, you know, all that stuff. So thank you for this award again, and go Friars.
We ask you now to please turn your attention to the video board for a special announcement to celebrate our athletic director, Bob Driscoll.
Friar Cup is an annual competition between all Friar athletic teams based on team academics, team performance, involvement in community service, and participation in athletic-sponsored events. Rachel Bartholomew-Guar, a softball student-athlete from the class of 07, and Ronnie Westgate, a lacrosse student-athlete from the class of 2006, helped to develop the Friar Cup idea along with Bob at the NCAA Leadership Conference. On Thursday, members of the SAC board presented Bob with a scrapbook filled with thank you notes from Friar student-athletes. Led by our student athletic Advisory Council, we are excited to announce we are renaming the award from the Friar Cup to the Driscoll Cup in honor of Bob Driscoll and everything he has done for Providence College. This award represents the most respected team who competes for championships while striving for 100% graduation. The three pillars Bob has stood by his entire career in Friar Town.
It is now time to announce the winners of the 2021 and 2022 Driscoll Cup Award. The Driscoll Cup is a competition between all Friar athletic teams based on team academics, team performance, involvement in community service, and participation in athletic-sponsored events. The winning team receives $1,000, second place gets $500, and third place gets $250. This year's third place team is Women's Swimming and Diving. This year's second place team is field hockey. And now the winner of the Driscoll Cup, this year's winner is lacrosse. Would the seniors please come up and accept the 2021-2022 Driscoll Cup?
Take it, man. as you want.
Okay. Well, I guess I'm the closing remarks. I was telling Nate that imagine having your own Driscoll Cup, but as a hockey player, you know what they do with the Stanley Cup. They drink lots of beer out of it, so that's what we're going to have to do once I retire. I can't do it now because I'll get fired, but I promise you I'll come back at some point and present it, and we'll sing and dance. We'll have some fun. So I just want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart. You have created a culture that is second to none. And as I told the freshmen when they got their awards earlier tonight for letter award, that cultures are fragile. It's up to you as individuals to make it great and special. I promise you there's not a lot of places in the country that have the kind of love and support that you have across the board. So appreciate it, have gratitude for it. And there's the next level. There's an entire next level what's possible if you work hard enough. Love you very much. Be safe tonight and go Friars.
Conclude our All-Sports Gala, but before we let you go, we would like to celebrate this year's graduating seniors with our annual tribute video.
Check. Check.
One, two, check.
Nice.
There it is.
Memories here were last year when we went to the NCAA tournament. It was a great experience, and that whole season I think was just a great season, a great team.
We went to Bemidji my sophomore year. We had a really cool experience. I remember we were in the hotel and there was balconies and we were on the lake and it was really fun. I would like to thank my family, my friends, especially my roommates for getting me through all the tough times. My coaches, the athletic training staff, Jesse, Coach Amy, you've done everything for us, and we're so grateful.
I would also like to thank my family, all my friends, and all the teammates I've had here throughout the years, as well as the whole athletic department, athletic trainers, Coach Amy, like Sarah said, she's been great with us.
Favorite memory here at Providence College that I have is just honestly any time that I get to spend time with my friends and my teammates.
Late Night Madness in 2019 when Boogie and John Legend came.
Last year during COVID when we had to fly out to Nebraska to play Creighton and we still pulled off that win with just 7 players, and that moment right there to me just stuck with me.
I would like the chance to thank from Jill and Bob, the coaching staff, to Caitlin O'Malley, to the trainers, Grace and Kristen. Honestly, my teammates and everyone that I've been able to meet.
To my coaching staff, special thank you to you guys.
Being able to be taken in and learn from so many different people and different perspectives.
I would just like to say a special thank you to every single teammate that I've had on this journey throughout my 4 years here, whether you stayed, transferred, or whatever. You guys all have meant so much to me on this journey. One thing that I will remember is Slang Gang. This, anytime anybody hit a three, even me, you know, OG Boom Squad right here. What do we say? 1, 2, 3, boom.
My favorite memory, or I guess memorable event, was my sophomore year. We went on a training trip to Puerto Rico and we ended up experiencing like a 6.5 magnitude earthquake. And I remember waking up in the middle of the night to the bed shaking, and I was scared out of my mind, but it ended up being a really great bonding experience for the team. And it's one of those things that only a select few are gonna ever experience, and it really brought us together in the end.
Eating in Ray, busy class schedule and everything, and maybe my like roommates don't have the same lunchtime as I do, but no matter what, like I can step into Ray, go to a table, and within a minute or two, I have my teammates surrounding me and we're eating together. And it's nice because it's a lot of times it's the people I don't normally get to see other than at practice or at swim meets. I, of course, want to thank all of my coaches and all of my teammates. They've become my family, so I'm extremely grateful for that, and it means the world to me.
My parents, especially my mom, she was there to support me through it all, and I really wouldn't have been able to swim here at Providence if it wasn't for them. Second, I want to thank my coaches, John and Mark.
And then, of course, I want to thank my parents and my brother because they're really the reason that I was able to make it to Friartown.
My favorite memory from my time here would be, we called it the Spring Break Foreign Tour. My freshman year, we did a trip to Spain where we played field hockey and just, we were all tourists. We like went around Spain, going to restaurants, seeing different places. Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
Last year when we were playing during COVID and we were having a really tough time, with 1 second left, we ended up turning around and beating Quinnipiac. So that was really cool. And I feel like it just kind of lifted our spirits a lot, and we definitely needed it.
I would like to thank all the coaches, Coach Maddle, Leslie, Kelly, the athletic training staff, Grace and Kristen, all past and present teammates.
All of those people play such an important role in our time here. We really love the sport that we do because all of them. Yeah, without them, we just wouldn't be able to do what we do. So thank you all so much.
Favorite memory probably at Marshall this past year. You know, they were the defending national champions. I think they're top five ranked team in the NCAA. I feel like a lot of people were doubting us that we were going to be going there. They had been undefeated at home for, I think, a year and a half. On the road, we were down 1-0. And, you know, by the end of the game, we came back and we won 2-1. First off, I'd like to thank Coach Craig, Coach JM, Coach DeMello, Coach Bacher, and in the past, Coach Spratty. Next, I'd like to thank Coach White and Coach Nat, you know, always for keeping our team in shape and in the offseason, just making sure we're training. Bob Driscoll and all the other administrative staff for supporting our team, for our community. You know, without them, our games would be empty and, you know, wouldn't have the same atmosphere that we have right now.
Obviously, the one that stands out was Frozen Four freshman year. I mean, it's just a great experience. But beyond that, when I'm done here, I'm just going to remember, like, my time with the guys in the locker room or, you know, in the dorm room. And nights here at Schneider where we had big crowds and got big wins is what I'll remember the most and I'll definitely cherish.
The Frozen Four, for sure. Some of the trips we've taken, Vegas, most recently to Milwaukee this year, spending some time with the guys. And that's really what it's all about, I think, for me, looking back on it. Teammates, first and foremost, you know, without them, I think they make this whole thing click and make it so special. Coaching staff, you know, preparing us on the ice, obviously, but also instilling, you know, values enough in us that go beyond the ice. All the rest of the staff, Teresa, Nina, Zags, Nikki, RJ, and the whole rink staff, just kind of making this whole thing click. And obviously my family showing up to every game, grandparents as well, so.
Obviously my teammates, incredibly thankful for them. I've had some unbelievable ones over the years. And, you know, the coaching staff, all they've done for me and for our program while I've been here, and can't thank them enough too. And obviously my family, couldn't do it without them too and their support. I said best 4 years of my life, I would say easily. And, you know, I'm going to miss it for sure.
My first Big East meet, it was my first year here and we were in the DMR and we ended up winning it, but no one had actually run the DMR before. We didn't really know what to expect and it was all our first time there. So we just went out and gave the lash and that was pretty cool.
Yeah, all the trips are all really good. The NCAA cross country last November was probably one of the best ones we went on. It was just a really cool experience because I'd never been to a meet like that before. And then it was also like a small group of us as well. So I think there was 8 or 9 of us in total. So it wasn't like, it was really nice to just have everyone there.
There's not one person that I would thank. I feel like from Bob Driscoll to the coaches to my teammates, everyone's just made it such an enjoyable experience. And you really do get the sense that everyone's rooting for you to be successful. So there's so many important people here that have made my time so special.
Favorite memory on the court?
It's hard. It'd either be between my big shot at BC, just because I was back home, I got to perform in front of my family and friends, or even a big shot at Marquette. They were both on the road, so I got to silence the crowd. I love when you silence the crowd. It's just something about that. Starting my prior career with 7 threes and then ending it with 7 threes against Creighton for the Big East Championship. So those are my favorite memories here.
I want to thank so many people just for embracing me and making my time at Friartown something special. Obviously, Coach Cooley and his staff, Coach White, the training room staff, Chris's office, the athletic training office, you know, the fans. My time at Friartown wouldn't be the same without them.
Yeah, first.
My favorite memory of my 4 years at Providence College is probably Big East last year. My closest friends, Justin and Kevin, actually won Big East championships. And to top it all off, Coach John, Marge, and Regis all won Big East coaching staff of the year.
Going on the boys' trip with the men's swim team. After training trip, the guys and girls team split because the girls had to go home for a home meet. And we went to go race Villanova. I just think that overall, the vibes are really good. Everyone's really positive. We swam well, and we gave Villanova a really tough race, so I was really happy with that.
Yeah, I'd like to thank Coach John, Coach Marge, Ken, Kev. I'd like to thank my parents and my sisters as well for supporting me.
My teammates, the ones that have always supported me through the highs to the highs, the lows to the lows, always have my back, always there when I need someone to talk to.
For me, it would probably be like the simple times, you know, like when we're just hanging out together, probably at Ray, you know, we're there for like 4 or 5 hours just talking, which is great.
I think they really bring out our genuine selves. I think in those times we're not trying too hard to like impress anyone or anything like that. I think it's just us in our natural state.
I would like to thank Ray, Tim, and Kat first. I really appreciate everything they've ever done for me.
I also want to thank all the athletic trainers for helping me through injuries throughout the past 4 years.
For my teammates, I love you all so very much. And
it's not just a temporary relationship that I have with them. They're lifelong relationships that I can go to them in 10, 20 years and it'll be just like old times.
Memory is beating Villanova twice in the same weekend and making the Big East tournament. So we'd want to thank Margot, of course, and Richie, Cole, our GA, Coach Nat, and Sam, our trainer, and most of all, our teammates, and Caitlin O'Malley and OAS.
I would say my favorite memory was probably my sophomore year. We went to Texas, we were the underdogs, and we won in overtime. So it was pretty cool being an underdog winning against a big time school.
I think hands down NCAA tournament, especially during our senior year, it was just a really fun trip and no one really expected us to make it. So I think, as she said, we were pretty much underdogs there too.
That moment when we found out we made it was pretty insane. Special.
Yeah.
I think we would both like to thank our coaches, our trainer Michelle, our lifting coaches, Coach Amy, Coach Rick, Coach Anderson.
Administration, especially our teammates, just for encouraging us and inspiring us to be us every single day.
My favorite memory on the field would have to be winning the Ocean State Cup my sophomore year. It was the year COVID hit and we kind of had to go home, but at the time we were doing really well.
Our sophomore year, we got to travel to Utah for a preseason game. And that was a great experience. We spent 4 to 5 days all together. Got to do a lot of sightseeing, got to go around the town a little bit.
And we went to the Olympics.
Went to the Olympic Village. Went to a steak, like a Brazilian steakhouse, and they just kept giving us like piles of meat every single time. We were trying to stop them, but they just kept piling it on. Horrible sweats afterwards. It was not great, you know, for the body, but it was so fun being there with everybody on your team.
First off, I'd like to thank my family at home. Next, I'd like to thank the coaching staff here at Providence with the head coach, Chris Gabrielli, and the assistants, Kevin Gould and Matt Francis.
I'd also like to thank our strength and conditioning coaches, Coach Anderson and Coach Rick.
Especially Lindsay. She has one of the hardest jobs on campus.
Bob Driscoll, Nina Bymark, Kevin Connolly, Jonah Castro, everything that you guys do. It's never unnoticed in our locker room.
My favorite memory is probably just playing hockey with the team. I think it's been something that has brought us together, brought out some competitiveness, something we put our own spin to. We've got our own rules, got our own hockey council. We have a lot of fun with it.
It was at North Carolina when 4 of our teammates hit home runs back to back, and that was really cool. So I want to thank our teammates, Coach Amy, Coach Anderson, Coach Rick,
Yeah, I think we also want to thank our trainer, Sam. He does a lot for the team, puts in a lot of hours. We really appreciate him. Jen Cunningham, we don't get to see her as much as we'd like to, but we know that she's working for us behind the scenes. The rest of our coaching staff, Coach Bree, Coach K, Coach Stacy, Coach Kelsey, we know the amount of work that you guys are putting in. A lot of it's unseen. We really appreciate you.
Time. Seniors, come on stage to take a picture, and just one last time, give me the best Go Friars. Ready? One, two, three, Go Friars! All right, have a great night.